If you're looking for a fun, good-looking car that breaks the traditional mold of what a subcompact SUV should be, the 2021 Mazda CX-30 is here. The new CX-30 does so many things well and goes mostly unchanged for 2021 since being introduced last year. However, Mazda couldn't sit still and added a new feature many people have been asking for and a brand new engine option for 2021. If you're interested, let's get started. Today I'm behind the wheel of a Mazda CX-30, and this is the newest SUV introduced within Mazda's lineup, and that brings the total SUV lineup count to 4. If you've been car shopping for a while, I'm sure you noticed that the car manufacturers tend to copy each other. There's almost like an unwritten rule of what you can't do within a certain segment. The CX-30 breaks the mold, because Mazda decided to change a few things. First thing is with the engine. You actually get 186 horsepower under the hood. This is the same SkyActiv engine that's used in a CX-5, at least the base engine of CX-5. And Mazda decided to put that in the CX-30. That means this has almost 40 more horsepower than the CX-3 and at least 30 to 40 horsepower more than the competition.
Now, even though this base 2.5 liter engine is already leaps and bounds above the competition, Mazda wants to give buyers even more power. It was confirmed last minute that later this year, Mazda will bring over the turbo 2.5 liter from the CX-5 and the CX-9 into the CX-30. This turbo engine produces 250 horsepower and 320 pound-feet of torque. This turbo engine will definitely make the CX-30 the most powerful and the quickest SUV in this segment.
Other ways that Mazda is trying to break the mold with the CX-30 is with the looks on the outside and with the features and quality on the inside. If you look at the outside of the CX-30, it's definitely Mazda, but it's in a really good way, especially with this metallic red that I have on this car. It looks gorgeous, and the whole design of a Mazda has that elegance and sophistication, and also has a really good stance. In my opinion, into a subcompact SUV segment, there is no other SUV that looks better than the CX-30. And I love on this one, you see the roof rails. It's really good looking aluminum roof rails, really beefy, and they match up with the window surround. The side profile, the way the belt line is and the large wheels, you just take a look at it. This is one good looking SUV. So that's another way Mazda is trying to break the mold with the subcompact SUV segment. Instead of boring and bland, they're giving something that's really good looking and something that makes you excited about. Now inside the CX-30, Mazda is also trying to break the mold of bland and boring and cheap and giving you something that looks really good, very high quality, and for the most part, it works well. Starting with the steering wheel, outside the base trim, any other trim above will give you a leather-wrapped steering wheel. The design looks great. I like Mazda's steering wheel design. It looks modern, sleek, and the buttons, they look aluminum, and it just looks good. But I was mentioning this leather feels actually like leather. Unlike a lot of manufacturers where they say leather-wrapped steering wheel, I really doubt it. It just doesn't feel like leather. It doesn't feel soft. This one does. The steering wheel mated to the suspension setup is a beautiful thing. You guys know Mazdas tend to be on the sporty side, and it's no different with the CX-30. Steering feel is very precise. There's almost no play, like almost zero play, just like little like movement in the steering wheel like that. And I could feel the CX-30 moving, and it has the right weight. It doesn't feel very weighted. It doesn't feel very light. It's like right in between, and I like it. And the suspension, in terms of the dampers and springs, I'm taking a lot of local roads, and you know, there's a lot of places where there's patches, bumps, dips, and so forth, right? And you know what? I feel like it's very comfortable. It's a controlled suspension. So I think Mazda did excellent job tuning the suspension in here, as well as giving a really enjoyable steering feel, and this is fantastic. So I kind of went off track. Let's talk about still what's in here that's really good. Well, this digital gauge cluster inside, this is an optional on the upper trims, but this is a good looking info screen. And Mazda did it really well because in the middle, right, they put a physical bezel, right, but it's a screen. And it's showing you the speedometer, but inside they give you a lot of info that and you normally see, right, like your trip computer and so forth. But I like how the way Mazda integrated it, so it doesn't look like it doesn't belong. It looks really good. Now, moving on, let's talk about this infotainment screen. 8.8 inches, almost 9 inches, and this is a really good setup. Now, the way Mazda designed it is kind of indented into the dash, and they put it a distance away. And I'm guessing they did that on purpose because they don't want you to try to touch it, because it is not touch screen. You have to control it with this dial and button setup. But I will say, after spending just 30 seconds with it, this is a really easy setup. There's a return button if you want to use it. The dial actually feels pretty good, and you can scroll up and down. There's a quick button for music, for navigation. So it just works well, and I really like this. Now, would it be better with touch? Yeah, like the other Mazda models. This new graphical interface, this new software, it's actually really good, really responsive, really high-res screen. Now, the one problem I have with it is, if you go and look at your rear camera, your backup camera, it does not take up the whole screen. It's a small little square in the middle. Why not utilize the whole screen, right? This is actually a really good-looking, very bright, responsive, and high-res screen, so why not take advantage of it? And there's a lot of things you could scroll through. You can go into settings and change your safety features. You can turn on or off your heads-up display. Obviously, your navigation, your music, Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, those are all standard. So here's a little quirk. Under safety settings, there's something labeled pedal misuse alert. And the description says, alerts the driver when the accelerator and brake pedal are both depressed simultaneously. Is that a common thing to be warning people about? Wouldn't people just figure that out? Maybe not. As I'm coming to a stop, I'm noticing the pedal is a little bit stiffer than some of the others I've driven in this class or in general. It's not too bad. So it is a little stiffer. It requires you to put a little bit more effort into it. But after it starts catching on, it's a pretty linear feel, and the CX-30 comes to a stop pretty quickly. Now, in terms of visibility, it's a mixed bag, unfortunately. It could be better. Now, starting from the front, no problems. The windshield is really big. You have no problem seeing well over the hood, past the hood. So no problems looking frontwards. Now, the side, kind of mixed. The windows are okay. Decently big, but because of the high belt line and the very high door panels, it does get in the way a little bit. So I could see how if there was a very low car, maybe a child standing next to you, it would be very hard to see them. And to prove my point, take a look. I point the camera from my face level to the mirror. You could see how the bottom of the mirror is cut off by the door panel. That's what I'm talking about. The door panel and belt line is so high that it actually cuts into even the passenger mirror. Now, in terms of the blind spot, it's actually really bad in here. The way that C-pillar is and the rear window is designed, there's a lot being covered and hidden back there. So you do want to make sure, if you can, get the blind spot monitoring and rear cross-traffic alert features, which unfortunately is not offered in the base trim. It's offered in every other trim except the base trim, so keep that in mind. And it's unfortunate because in the CX-3, that is standard, but that's not standard in the CX-30. The rear visibility is okay. The middle headrest, even though it's all the way down, it still kind of blocks your view. I mean, I could see past the headrest, but they do block a lot of the vision back there. So in terms of overall vision in here, like the visibility, it's kind of so-so. Now, today is a relatively windy day, and I'm up to speed about 50, 55 miles per hour, and it is very quiet in here. So that's another thing that Mazda did an excellent job on in terms of just installation. It's really quiet in here. Again, especially for this class, and not really just for this class, just overall, I don't really hear anything. Really, nothing. I don't hear any wind noise. I don't hear any road noise. It's really quiet. Even engine noise, it's really, really subtle and toned down. Now, this CX-30 I'm driving today is the premium one, which is the upper trim, the highest trim you can get. And you get a lot in here. A lot of features that you typically don't find in this segment. For example, you get a power tailgate. You also get a heads-up display. This one is a really nice one, one of the best I've seen. Very bright, you can adjust it many different ways, the height, the brightness, what's being displayed, the speed limit, the miles per hour, navigation, blind spot warning, all that is displayed there. Now, one quirk about that is there's no physical button to turn it off, so you have to go into menu, go into settings to turn it off. And I have done that before, but it seems to turn on every single time you start the car. So it's not something that it's remembering. It doesn't remember that. So those of you guys that don't like it, you'll have to remember to turn off every single time. Other things that you get heated seats, automatic climate control. Those are pretty standard. A sunroof. Also, memory seats. That's nice. You know, in the upper segments, you'll see that. Basically, every car has that. But in the subcompact segment, you don't see that much. And also, of course, you get this nice leather throughout the cabin.
In the CX-30, you also get iActivSense, which is Mazda's safety technology, which includes emergency braking with smart brake support, lane departure warning, lane keep assist, radar guided cruise control with stop and go, auto high beam control, driver attention alert, blind spot monitoring, and rear cross traffic alert.
If you take a look at the trunk, it's okay. It gives you a decent amount of space because this is a SUV. However, compared to some of the others in this class, it's still lacking. Also, what's lacking back there is there's no handles to fold down the second row. Also, there's no hidden storage of any kind or any storage space of any kind. Underneath the bottom cover, you get the spare tire, and that's it. So you have to figure out how to place things on your own. Now, moving on to the second row, that's where it gets disappointing. I'm 5'10". And take a look in the second row, my knees are already hitting the seat back, and the seat back is my usual driving position. So if you're trying to fit a couple 6-footers, you're not going to be able to. It's really cramped in the second row.
Another problem with the second row space is when you try to fold the seat backs down, if you don't move the front seats forward, they actually can't fold down.
So unfortunately, the second row is not very spacious, not very comfortable, and those of you guys on the taller side, you will not want to sit back there. Now, I mentioned a few kind of quirky slash bad things. There's a few things up here too. The door panels, because of how high they are, and I talked about how this kind of blocks visibility from the side, because of how high it is, it's very uncomfortable for you to put your arm up here. As you can see, this is a very uncomfortable spot because of how high it is. So unfortunately, you have to limit your elbows within the car. Also, the center armrest, it feels really nice. It's covered in this very soft leather, at least in this premium trim. But the way Mazda designed it, just, I don't know. Like, there's obviously a pull lever to open it. But when you first pull on it, it doesn't open. So you have to slide it back, and you have to slide it back to just the right point before you can lift it up and access the inside. Mazda decided to make it so that you can only open it after sliding it back, which will probably confuse some. By the way, these seats are actually really comfortable too. I like the way the seat holds me in. It's a little bit on the sporty side. I do feel the bolsters on my back holding me in, but it's not uncomfortable. And I like the bottom cushion too. So these front seats, really nice. I feel like I could drive for hours and still be okay. Now, unfortunately, the second row seats is not like that. It's small and it doesn't feel very good, and I wouldn't want to sit back there due to the size anyways for long periods of time. So if you're in the market for a brand new subcompact SUV, should you be looking at the CX-30? The answer is yes. you should. The CX-30 does so many things well. Mazda really broke the mold for what a subcompact SUV can be. This engine will instantly put this at the top of the list. Drive a CX-30 and then drive HR-V, CHR, a Rogue Sport, drive any of them after driving a CX-30, and you'll come out disappointed because of how underpowered all those SUVs are.
As for trim levels, there are four to the 2021 CX-30. The base trim starts at $23,300 with all-wheel drive, then the Select, Preferred, and finally the Premium, which starts right under $30,000. Pricing info has not been released yet about the new 2.5-liter turbo engine. To conclude, the Mazda CX-30 is a fantastic subcompact SUV that does so many things well, but isn't perfect. The base engine already puts it above others in this class. However, the new turbo engine will really set the CX-30 apart. The exterior looks and interior cabin quality are outstanding. The standard features are also impressive, and the infotainment system and digital info screen works well. The CX-30 is also nimble, comfortable, quiet, and drives great. However, the CX-30 has a cramped second row, visibility is subpar, especially with a blind spot, and blind spot monitoring and rear cross traffic alert is not offered on the base trim. Also, the center armrest design could be better. Overall, I'm giving the brand new 2021 Mazda CX-30 a score of 95. To see where it ranks, check out driversonlyrankings.com. Thanks for watching. Hit the like and subscribe to the channel for more reviews, first looks, and news.